Sloane Stephens was born on March 20, 1993, to Sybil Smith and John Stephen in Plantation, Florida. Her mother was the first African-American woman in Division I history to be named an All-American first-team swimmer. Stephens' father was a Pro Bowl running back in the National Football League for the New England Patriots. Stephens' parents separated when she was a baby after his father's multiple arrest in 1994. Stephen was raised by her mother and her stepfather, Sheldon Farrell, who married Smith in 1997 and worked as a business consultant. The union was blessed with a son, Shawn Farrell, who played baseball and football. It was not until she was 13 that Stephens talked with her biological father. He had showed interest in getting to know her after he was diagnosed with degenerative bone disease. Stephen's stepfather passed away from cancer in 2007, while her biological father died in a car crash in 2009. Stephen relocated to her mother's hometown of Fresno in California at age of 2. At the age of 9, she began playing tennis at the Sierra Sport and Ratchet Club, a tennis center located across the street from her house where her stepfather played regularly and her mother was taking classes. Farrell served as Sloane's primary inspiration for beginning to play the sport. Former professional Francisco Gonzalez, the club's head tennis coach, recognized the talents of young Stephens and suggested that she seek more intensive training programs. 2 years later, Stephens relocated to Boca Raton in Florida and began training at the Event Tennis Academy founded by John Evert. Stephens moved to the Nick Saviano High Performance Tennis Academy at age 12 and also began homeschooling online there. In 2016, Stephens began competing at low-level events on the ITF Junior Circuit at age 13, and the next year, she made her professional debut on the ITF Women's Circuit. In 2008, she lost a series of events before defeating world number 109 Melinda Shinsk while at age 15. Stephens won her first professional championship in doubles at a low-level ITF 10K tournament in Wichita with partner Christina and McHill during the summer of 2008. In March 2010, Stephens started the year ranked number 802 at the Indian Wells Open and finished at number 198. Stephens continues to climb the WTA charts and won her first professional singles title in Camparini-Gioielli Cup, an ITF 50K tournament in Italy, to lift to a world-class career best of number 128. Stephens made her first appearance in the top 100 WTA rankings later that August and became the youngest female player in the top 100 at the age of 18. The next year, she rose to the top 50 of the WTA ranking for the first time. The athlete played at the City Open in late July through the French Open but was not able to secure a place at the Olympics due to a torn abdominal muscle. However, she finished the year as the youngest player in the top 50 at number 38. In 2013, Stephens encountered the world number 3, Serena Williams. Though Williams won the match in straight sets, Steve pulled off a huge upset in the second clash, shocking Williams. This was Stephens' first top 10 career win, which made her much more famous, and after the event, saw her climb to a record number 17 spot. The tennis prodigy managed to pull off another Grand Slam tournament performance at the French Open despite suffering abdominal muscle injury, where she beat three unseeded opponents, but she lost to number 2, Maria Sharapova, and the eventual champion, Marion Bartoli. Stephens recorded her second major upset of the year at the Cincinnati Open in August when she knocked out Sharapova, the world's number 3 star, in the second round, while she lost to number 15 Jelena Jankovic in the next round. She rose to world number 12 at the end of the year and was one of the just 3 players to make it into the second week of all 4 2013 Grand Slam tournaments alongside Williams and Agnieszka Rawanska. Also in October, Stephens achieved a number 11 career high ranking and became the second highest ranked American. In the ensuing tournaments, Sivan didn't do well. She lost to number 109 Maria Kirilenko at Wimbledon and subsequently to number 96, Joanna Larsson, at the US Open after committing 63 unforced errors. She ended the season placed number 37 in the world. In the clay court season, Stephens got off to a slow start, only managing to upset world number 15, Venus Williams, defeated world number 9, Carla Suarez Navarro, for her first top 10 victories in almost 2 years. Stephens entered a winning spree at the City Open in August without dropping a set for her first career WTA title. The title put Stephens back in top 30. Stephens appointed Kamau Mori as her new coach in the offseason. Under him, Stephens won her first tournament with the two of them together at the Auckland Open. Nonetheless, Stephens was forced to play number 17 Caroline Wozniacki at the close of a semi-final match and as well as the entire final against Julia Gorges on the same day to clinch the title owing to a rain delay. Stephens struggled through the 2016 season due to a fracture. She underwent surgery that kept her out for the first half of the 2017 as well. Stephens was ranked number 22 in the world at the end of her last WTA event of the year in late July. However, she was granted the privilege to broadcast for the tennis channel and also used the free time to obtain a BSc degree in communication studies. By the time she returned to the WTA tour in July for the Wimbledon, her ranking had dropped to number 336 and even dipped more as number 957. But she reached the semi-finals of both the Premier 5 tournaments that month, the Canadian Open and the Cincinnati Open, climbing back into the top 100 of the WTA rankings. She defeated number 10 Dominika Sibulkova and number 33 Julia Gorges at the US Open to progress to her first quarterfinal in the US Open and her first quarterfinal since Wimbledon in 2013. Stephens beats number 17 Anastasija Sevastova to set up the first All-American semi-final since Wimbledon in 1985 and the US Open since 1981. She won number 9 Venus Williams in the semi-finals and ended the event by beating Keys in straight sets to earn her first Grand Slam championship title. The athlete became the first American female player to win a major title than the Williams sisters since Jennifer Capriati won the 2002 Australian Open and the first to win the 1998 US Open since Lindsay Davenport. Thus, she became the lowest-ranking US Open champion ever and the fifth lowest in any Grand Slam event. Stephens didn't play another match the rest of the season since the US Open. Nevertheless, the United States claimed the game 3-2 to hand Stephens its first Fed Cup title. This was the United States' first term since 2000. Stephens ranked number 13 in the season and was named the year's WTA comeback player. At the Australian Open, Stephens lost a series of games but bounced back to win the Miami Open, her first premier mandatory title. At the game, she beat three top 10 players to climb for the first time to top 10. At the French Open, the prolific athlete dabbled between wins and losses but rose to number 4 in the world and number 3 in the singles rankings after the tournament. This made her the first American female player other than the Williams sisters to rise to the top 5 in singles since Lindsay Davenport in 2006. The champ lost her title at the US Open to Anastasija Sevastova in the quarterfinals. The next season, she lost her first 8 games of the match against Karolina Pliskova but recovered and won the match in straight sets. Stephens won the first set against Elena Svitolina in her final game of the season but eventually lost the match. She finished ranked number 6 in the world for the season. Stephens is an all-court player. She loves to play behind the baseline and excel at countering powerful hit shots. She was a more solid swing with her two-handed backhand and favors a forehand. Unlike her fellow top-ranked American contemporaries, Stephens prefers a passive approach to aggressive. Stephens has enjoyed and is still enjoying a series of endorsements for her illustrious career. She is widely represented by the TLA and has Nike as a sponsor since the start of 2018. Since 2010, her clothing sponsor has been Under Armour. Stephens has been using head rackets, specifically Graphene XT Radical Pro model since 2018. Stephens' favorite player as a young aspirant was Kim Klitschko, who congratulated Stephens in person after her 2017 US Open title. She also idolized the Williams sisters and kept a poster of Serena in her bedroom as a kid, but was offended that they didn't sign her autograph at one of their events she attended. However, Stephens has developed a good relationship with the Williams sisters. Stephens established her own charity, Sloane Stephens Foundation. The foundation builds tennis courts and set up after-school tennis programs for underserved students in conjunction with supplementary tutoring, which is run by Stephens, her mother, and her uncle, Ronald Smith. They have organized programs in Compton, Fresno, and Fort Lauderdale. Also, she has worked with Souls for Soul, a charity that collects new and used shoes to give to children in poverty. Stephens is currently dating and is engaged to Josie Altidor, a US national soccer team member who has also been one of her childhood friends since living in Florida. Previously, she dated Jack Sock, a fellow American tennis player, for over a year. Thank you very much for watching this video. We'd like to give you another exciting video for you to enjoy next. But before then, our team will be thrilled if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.